As a child, they kept him in a crumbling house, a building with structural moans, whose eaves cracked in summer heat and gathered winter ice. At that point, Moldinki's chest held two lungs and a single heart. He experienced a shortened boyhood, a small degree of youth and carelessness. Most phenomena puzzled him and sent him on aimless walks among the leafless ether trees. He would fix on his goggles, his gauze pad, and study the flying birds. See them casting frightened earthward glances. He would press his face against the pane of his bedroom lookout as spring fell and wait for the green bird. The green bird would circle a dying ether, peck spirals on its dry trunk, writing down its habits, behaviors, and essences. Rapid pecking, followed by pauses, long agile tongue coated with a jelly-like substance. Good for rooting in tree trunks, for larvae, and etc., when the tongue is protracted, it apparently wraps about the brain.
Things were loose in those days for Moldinki. He was free and new green, bright suns behind him, spirals ahead.
Took him to a sun-choked acre of grasses and weed where a snow of pollen lay yellow on the ground, a place like a rotunda, obviously complete. although nothing suggested architecture.
There was no apparent ceiling and no visible dome.
Warm winds would lap at his stringy hair arrangement.
He would feel no pulse, faint metabolism, conscious only of the hum and flow.
He would recall what Dr. Bernhard had said to him on one occasion.
Take wing, Moldenki. Life is flight if you choose to ride the updrafts.
He would circle the acre in pollen silence with his better ear open. The silence would give way to a labored breathing, the sound of a single lung in difficulty. Then on a cue from no visible source, something with mudded claws would spit clots from surrounding bushes.
Moldenki would imagine himself turning away, his chin on his chest, one hand in a pocket. The Moldenki mind was airy, like a dirigible,
loosed from its tethers.